titties, breasts, boobs, boobies. I feel like I've heard them called sandbags before, which I don't know how to feel about that.
My name is Keith Blechman. I'm a plastic surgeon practicing in New York, and my specialty is breast reductions. I've been performing breast reductions throughout my entire practice, so about 6 to 7 years. I mean, I like to think I'm making the world smaller one breast at a time. A lot of the breast reductions we do are quite large, and so many pounds are taken off a patient's chest. It changes their whole functionality of their back and their neck, reduces pain, it gives them a much better cosmetic appearance, and generally improves their self-esteem and gets them back into just a better place in their lives.
Hi, I'm Caitlin. I'm 22 years old and I'm considering a breast reduction. I've been thinking about a breast reduction for almost five years now, but seriously considering actually getting it done, maybe more like a year and a half. Large chests run in my family. I knew that growing up, but I didn't realize that it was gonna have the physical impact on my body that it has. I've had back problems, shoulder problems. Exercising is so much harder. I mean, I can't run without either a serious sports bra or two of them. Clothes don't fit the way that I want them to because I have a tiny waist and then a huge chest and everything fits like a paper bag.
Plastic surgeons have been performing breast reductions for at least 50 years. Over the last couple of decades, the popularity has increased a little bit, and that's probably due to just more awareness of the procedure, things like social media, bringing the presentation out to the public, and there's been some new techniques, some new developments and innovations that are just making it a more sought-after procedure. A breast reduction is a cosmetic operation, but at the same time, there's more to it. There's a functional concern below that. So removing all this weight off the chest allows them to just have so much less discomfort. I mean, I've seen patients post-operatively completely are leading almost different lives now since their surgeries. A whole different regimens of lifestyle change, including exercise. Interestingly, cosmetics are almost secondary to the functional concerns, but it's great that we can really treat both. And in general, nearly 100% of the patients are just very happy with their choice to go through with the surgery.
If I had a breast reduction, I think I would feel so much more confident. More confidence physically, more confidence emotionally, just being able to walk around and feel like all of my body actually fits, like it's truly mine the way it's meant to be and not this extra part of me that just feels really uncomfortable.
So there's different types of breast reductions. That term is kind of an umbrella term. There's those that involve scars and those that don't. So the ones that don't, what we're really talking about is liposuction of the breast. But it's important to understand if you're gonna seek out liposuction of the breast that that's only gonna remove fat from your breasts and not breast tissue. So there's only a small subset of patients where that really is a good operation for. It's typically gonna be smaller breasts and you're not looking to have a very big breast reduction. To really take tissue out, you have to cut into the skin, and so that's what leaves the scars. And there are two main types of scar patterns for breast reductions. There's the vertical or lollipop incision, which is the circle around the areola with the line that comes down. There's also the anchor shape incision, which is the circle around the areola, the line that comes down, and then that smiley face that's under the breast. Most breast reductions do not require the nipple and areola to be removed. And because they're not removed, they retain their blood supply. And this will allow you to have continued sensation and the ability to breastfeed after surgery. That being said, there can always be changes to the sensation or the ability to breastfeed just because of the nature of the surgery. It's impossible to predict how that might change, and especially if you've never breastfed before. If you can't breastfeed after a breast reduction, it's not necessarily because of the breast reduction. But most patients don't seem to have too much of a problem with it.
I've done sort of peripheral research, I think, sort of looking into how much it might cost, what the usual impact on your body is in terms of the scars, things like that. But it is sort of a terrifying thing to contemplate, just willingly putting myself through a surgery that's technically unnecessary. Everybody would call it a cosmetic procedure. I would disagree, but.
So the cost is gonna vary. It's gonna depend on where it's done, who does it, and what exact type of operation you're having done. Cost could range anywhere between $7,500, even up to $15,000 to $20,000. And again, there's a lot of variables involved and each case is unique. When patients come in and they want to find out, will this breast reduction be covered by my health insurance? Even if the answer is yes, it does not necessarily mean that it's free. It's important for people to understand what their health insurance is, if they owe a deductible, a co-insurance, if they're going out of network, in network. You have to demonstrate some kind of functional problem, being that there's maybe discomfort in your back or neck, not due to anything else, like some kind of spine problem. It has to interfere with either your work or something at home. Oftentimes patients will have rashes under their breast that need some kind of prescription medication for. And then there's gonna be an estimated weight to be removed. That's typically based on either your body mass index or body surface area, and these are just numbers that come from your height and weight. And there's charts that they use to determine what the amount of weight that should come off is for you in particular. So let's talk about the pros and cons of breast reduction surgery. Well, one of the pros is that, as I mentioned, it's a life-changing operation. If you're having a large breast reduction done, you're gonna feel a significant weight off your shoulders and just feel better all around. It's an easy operation to get through. Although it may seem scary to most, it's actually quite straightforward. Most plastic surgeons are well-versed in doing breast reductions. It can be done as an outpatient, and there's definitely strategies to reduce pain significantly and get you back to work or school in a week or less. A big complaint we hear from patients coming in seeking a breast reduction is that they cannot find bras or clothes that fit them. And so after surgery, it's just such a change for them to be able to go shopping and find what makes them feel good. Now I'm going to take you through the cons. So breast reduction is a surgery. It's a big surgery. It's general anesthesia. Scarring after a breast reduction is just part of the package. You just have to weigh the pros and cons of whether you want to have the operation done and whether you're willing to accept the scar on your breast. There's just no way to remove so much tissue and not put a scar on the breast. Now, unless you're extremely lucky, scars will never completely go away. But there are things you can do to try to make them fade a little bit and be a little less noticeable. Fortunately, the scars are at least on the part of the breast that wouldn't be seen if you're in a swimsuit or in a bra for that matter. So they are somewhat hidden. It's very common to have some changes in nipple sensation, especially right after surgery. But in most cases, over the next few months, patients get at least some of their sensation back on both sides. The human body can take anywhere from 6 months to a year and a half to stabilize the changes that happen from a surgery. So things like scars, swelling, sensations in the breast, usually by about 3 to 6 months have stabilized to some degree, but it could be a whole other year until those changes have finally settled in.
I do have outside influences who are telling me that, oh, your body is great the way that it is, or my partner, I mean, like, I know that he's very comfortable with who I am as I am. I'm still not at a place in my life in general where it's a conversation that I'm ready to have with everyone other than myself.
So now the big question, is breast reduction worth it? 98% of RealSelf members said the surgery was worth it. And in my patients, it's closer to 100, but... For those who said it wasn't worth it was mostly because of asymmetry or scarring problems. However, it's important to know that most of the time, asymmetry or scarring issues can be addressed through minor revisions after surgery. Have you had a breast reduction? Tell us about it. And make sure to subscribe to RealSelf for more videos like this.